You're watching WDSU.
Now on WDSU breaking news, a tanker truck explodes at a gas station, killing the driver. What sparked the fire and what firefighters are doing now?
Ebola outbreak. An American cameraman working for NBC News has contracted the deadly virus in Liberia. The condition of the crew member.
Plus, new parking meters are going up downtown. The new features and details of a new parking policy for people with special needs. Now on WDSU.
This is breaking news from WDSU.
And out of that breaking news, a tanker truck explodes, sending flames shooting hundreds of feet into the air.
Now, this all happened at 2 o'clock this morning at a gas station located at the intersection of Franklin and North Claiborne Avenues. That's where we find WDSU news reporter Casey Ferran with more on how it all started. Casey.
Just confirmed just a few moments ago that the driver of the truck was killed in this fire. And right now I'm talking to Chief Tim McConnell to tell us a little more about what we do know about the accident that possibly caused all this to happen.
The accident is still under the accident is still under investigation. Not really sure what caused it at this point. So I don't really want to comment on that because the police and my investigators are working on that. We do know we have a fatality at this time. We are not sure exactly who it is. We believe it could be the driver, but all of that is still under investigation right now.
And right now, I mean, obviously this is in really close proximity to a gas station. Talk about the danger that was facing your firefighters and people in the area.
Well, obviously, anytime you have a tanker of this size, this truck would hold about 8,500 gallons. It's a serious hazard. When you combine that with a gas station, a fairly large gas station with all the other fuel that they would have, the fuel is stored underground. And none of the pumps were affected. So, you know, there are safety precautions and all of that. But for us, you know, just that amount of fuel alone is certainly, you know, a major risk. And then you can't use water to fight it. So it takes a lot of resources and a lot of logistics to get set up to put a fire like that out. Once you get them in place, we got it out pretty quick.
You said that the rain possibly kind of affected the fire so putting it out as well.
Yeah, what happens is to put out a petroleum fire like this, you put down a foam blanket, which basically is a chemical product that we put down that separates the oxygen from the fuel. And as you have rain, and the kind of rain we had today, the heavy rain, well, it breaks that blanket, that we call it a blanket of foam on top. It breaks up that blanket, so then you have a chance for reignition. So we, you know, it causes a little bit of concern, but once they got it out with the first blanket of foam, they managed to maintain that blanket despite the rain. And the firefighters did a fantastic job really getting
it. We noticed one of the firefighters was being taken away on a
we
stretcher.
Did not have, we have not had any firefighters taken away at all. I'm not sure, you know, who that was. We can check with EMS for you, but we have no reports of any firefighters being transported
so no
at this time.
Injuries at this point.
Correct.
All right, great. Thanks for your time.
No problem. Thank you.
All right, we'll stay here and give you more updates as they become available. Back to you.
Casey, thank you for that. And we want to show you this video that was sent into WDSU from a viewer when the fire first ignited around 2 o'clock this morning. You can see there in the background the explosion there. This started as a 3-alarm fire, but as you heard from the chief, it's since been downgraded to a 1-alarm fire. Crews have managed to get things under control this morning. And again, it's now listed as a 1-alarm. Also, right now, roughly 500 Entergy customers are in the dark. Now, the power went out in the same area around the same time as this deadly tanker truck fire. We don't know if this is because of the explosion. However, Entergy crews are on the scene. They're investigating this incident, and they tell us that power should be restored around 7:30 this morning. We'll keep you posted on that. We'll also bring you updates on this story on air and online at WDSU.com. Also, don't forget to download our smartphone app. There you can get all of our breaking news updates and alerts.
All right, and this is also breaking right now. More than 4,000 Entergy customers are out of power in Waggaman. Crews are on the scene working to find out what caused this power outage. Officials have not posted a restoration time for this outage here, but we are going to continue to follow this story and update you as soon as we get any developments.
Now, our other big story this morning, the weather. And right now, heavy rains and storms are moving through southeast Louisiana.
Yeah, let's go to meteorologist Quaylen Murphy for a look at how things are shaping up for us today. Quaylen?
Good morning, Randy and Sella. Rain working through right now, as we know, overspreading the region, taking up more real estate, more so along the North Shore, but spreading more inland as we go throughout the morning. This is the big picture now. Rain spreading in, but thankfully this line line of storms is much weaker than it was just even 6 hours ago. Most of the heavier rain and the lightning working offshore, but we do have some lightning for inland spots, including locations around Slidell, Bay St. Louis, working past the Wiggins area now and towards Biloxi in Mississippi. Around the metro area, a few isolated storms now starting to develop across the area. We'll zoom in on that thunderstorm here just south of Highway 90 so far near Venetia now. So that's what we're watching now. And then as we take a look to the south, south of Highway 90, we do have a few isolated storms. One of those isolated storms near Cocodrie now working to the east this morning. Quick moving storms, that's what we like because that helps prohibit or at least limit locally heavy rainfall potential. There's the front. It's still to the west. It will work through this morning and afternoon. Gusty winds along with these storms in the 30s for some spots, so keep that in mind. Temperatures 70s and lower 80s. They'll be dropping. I'll have details on that coming up.
All right, now for check of your roadways at 6:05. If you're traveling inbound from New Orleans East here, this is a live look at the high rise for you. No problem spots here. However, we have three areas that might cause you some trouble. First one, I-10 eastbound near Belle Terre. So that's near the LaPlace area. We do have an accident on that portion of the interstate. We also have a breakdown on the West Bank Expressway in the westbound direction over the Harvey Tunnel. That's blocking one lane. And of course, we have been telling you about this breaking news all morning long. So expect that intersection of North Claiborne and Franklin to be closed for some time as crews continue to investigate that deadly tanker fire that broke out early this morning.
At 6:06 now, an American freelance cameraman working for NBC News in Liberia has tested positive for Ebola. He will be flown back to the United States for treatment. Dr. Nancy Snyderman and three other NBC News employees have had contact with this person and will also be flown to the U.S. on a private plane. Snyderman tweeted that the crew member was getting good care and that they isolated themselves there, but once they get here to the United States, they are going to be under quarantine for the next 21 days.
Well, you'll soon see some changes to the city's parking meters downtown. The city is transitioning to new solar-powered parking meters. The first ones were installed earlier this week in the CBD, and pretty soon you'll see them popping up over there in the French Quarter. And by the end of the year, all parking meters in the city will be replaced with the new ones, which will also include video touch screens. The Director of Public Works will talk about the new meters today over at City Hall starting at 9 a.m. Also new this morning, a new handicap parking policy is in effect. The City Council passed an ordinance on Thursday eliminating fees for disabled residents and visitors. This is all part of an ongoing effort to make the city more accessible for people who are physically disabled. So those with handicapped tags or plates on their vehicles can now get 3 hours of free parking at metered spaces across the city.
Today it's all about the economy. President Obama is continuing his mission to bring attention to the economic recovery as we get closer to the midterm elections. Aixa Diaz is live in Washington this morning. Aixa, this comes as we prepare to get a job indicator of the economy's health.
That's right. The job numbers come out later this morning, Sela, for September. And while unemployment may have remained the same at about 6.1%, analysts are predicting the U.S. added 215,000 new jobs last month, and that would be an improvement from August, but it may not be enough to boost investor confidence. The president, though, is drawing attention to the economic recovery, highlighting the progress since the Great Recession. The president is promoting pocketbook issues ahead of the midterm elections.
The importance of focusing on the economy now, and in fact, throughout the Obama administration, is because that is the number one thing that affects working families, American families across the country, is what is happening, how much are they getting in their paychecks, how are they making ends meet.
And today, President Obama heads to Indiana to a steel factory there to talk with workers. A new APGFK poll, though, shows that most Americans surveyed believe Republicans are better at dealing with the economy than Democrats. Sulla.
Well, like I said, the last time the job numbers came out, there were fewer jobs added than expected. Do analysts think that's going to happen again this time around?
Well, some analysts actually don't even believe the August numbers were accurate. According to MarketWatch, they think those numbers will be relooked at because think about it. August is summertime. School is off. People take vacations. There are seasonal jobs to take into account. So they believe that things are going to be better this time around and the analysis and prediction won't be quite as off as it was for August. Sela.
Shall wait and see. Ike Diaz, thank you for that. The U.S. Labor Department will release the September employment data at 7:30 a.m. our time.
Now, at 6:09 and happening today, city leaders will be talking about how to break the cycle of crime here in the Crescent City. U.S. Attorney Kenneth Polite and several other area leaders are getting together today to host a symposium for change. They'll discuss poverty, homelessness, and the high rate of incarceration in the U.S., especially here in Louisiana, since we're one of the states with the highest numbers of incarceration. The symposium is happening later this morning at St. Anthony of Padua Church in Luling.
And new this morning, a violent career criminal has been sentenced to life in prison. Authorities say they proved that Keith Kisak had prior felony convictions for illegal discharge of a firearm, aggravated battery, and being a felon in possession of a firearm. You know, back in July, Kisak was charged with possession of contraband in prison, and at that time, he was awaiting trial for second-degree murder and attempted second-degree murder. At Thursday's court hearing, the state also showed his prison disciplinary record, which includes dozens of allegations for stabbings, fighting, and sexual abuse of other inmates. New this morning, a Belle Chasse High School student has been arrested on drug charges. The Plaquemines Parish Sheriff's Office says 17-year-old Trey Million was arrested and charged with marijuana possession and distribution. Now, officials say school administrators say Million was acting suspicious, so they searched his locker and he grabbed his backpack and tried to run. In his school bag, they found 15 small bags of weed, cigars, rolling papers, and $100 in cash.
Well, time now at 6:11 as we have your weather and traffic every 10 minutes here at WDSU. You know, we've been talking about this cold front. It's happening today, but it's also coming with some showers, so you've got to get through that first.
That's right. Getting through the rain first, getting through the gusty winds, the slick roadways, all of that that comes with and before the cold front. After the front is what we're looking forward to, Randy. Lots of sunshine for the weekend, but before the sunshine, clouds and rain, here they are here on our satellite radar working to the east right now. You can see probably where the most heavy rain is right now. It's to the west of I-55, still around Baton Rouge. Pushing to the east, we had a nice batch of rain around the North Shore, now lifting and pushing on to the east towards the Mississippi Gulf Coast. That's where we see some of the more moderate rainfall along with those thunderstorms, which are around Shoreline Park to Long Beach. Now heading towards Biloxi and the Wade area so far this morning. Wiggins starting to see more relaxed conditions as those showers tail off. Around Greensburg and Hammond, more moderate rain working in to the east. Laplace getting in on some rainfall and some thunder and lightning. Around the metro area, we are seeing some showers and storms around the Carrollton area. Things mainly quiet still for Bayou Gastro at this time. Jean Lafitte seeing some showers and storms as well. Galliano getting ready for a moderate downpour on the way. Again, the big picture showing that frontal boundary, which is still draped to our west. These showers and storms ahead of the front, behind the front, much drier air. And once that front passes, which will be later on this afternoon, we'll get in on the drier conditions, or at least the more clear conditions. Here's the forecast through 8 o'clock this morning. Rain and storms working in by noon today. Drier conditions, only isolated showers left. You can see some clearing as well from I-55 spreading towards the North Shore now. And then we'll see that clearing taking place in the South Shore around the river parishes. Clearing will continue through the afternoon hours into early evening. So we're looking at dry conditions and windy conditions. It'll be breezy throughout the afternoon and evening. Winds northeast 10 to 20 miles per hour. 72 degrees right now at the airport. Those temperatures dropping along the North Shore. Those winds gusting. Here they are, 33 miles per hour. So expect conditions to be changing. Visibilities fluctuating. Sala and Randy.
Quaylen, right now on the roadways at 13, rather, looking at a few problem spots. We've got an accident, I-10 westbound at Carrollton right now, blocking two right lanes of traffic. So that's, again, in the outbound direction, right past that Carrollton overpass as you're approaching City Park Avenue. We also have an accident for those of you traveling around Laplace on the interstate. This is eastbound near Belterre this morning, and we also have a breakdown on the West Bank along the West Bank Expressway westbound over the Harvey Tunnel.
A toddler is hit by an SUV and dies. We're going to tell you whom authorities think may be responsible. That and more coming up in your newspaper headlines.
6:17 now, and a 3-year-old boy dies after being hit by an SUV.
That tops your newspaper headlines this morning. The Shreveport Times reports a woman who is a family member pulled forward in the driveway of the residence and drove over the boy. She did not see the child. The toddler was transported to University Health, where he was later pronounced dead. His name has not been released. Now continuing our headlines in Baton Rouge.
And two teenagers were arrested for beating an 11-year-old boy at a school bus stop last week. According to The Advocate, 17-year-old Lorenzo Jones and a 16-year-old boy approached the 11-year-old behind a school bus. They began hitting him in the face, leaving, quote, severe swelling and bleeding near his mouth and eyes, and also leaving him unconscious and obviously disfigured. Jones was booked on one count of second-degree battery, and the 16-year-old was booked into a juvenile detention center.
Rain and storms working through the area this morning, but drier conditions this afternoon. We'll talk about that in my exact cast coming up.
Now at 6:20, as we have your weather and traffic every 10 minutes, a live look outside, and that camera is shaking.
It is very windy today, along with some rain as well. So Quaylen's here with a check of that.
Camera is grooving as the winds work through. The winds are gusting, guys, 15 to 25 miles per hour with some of the storms working through. So that's what we're experiencing now, along with the rainfall and the isolated storms. Here it is, satellite and radar showing that lapse. It's the last 2 hours. Rain moving in. I really appreciate this picture right now. I want you to as well, because it's not severe. None of these storms are severe. Some of them are strong, but again, not as strong as they were with our friends to the west, Texas areas around Nebraska. They were dealing with some hefty conditions yesterday. You can see the batch of rain now around Hammond, I-55, south towards South Vacherie. Around the metro area as well, we do have some showers and more moderate rainfall around Belle Chasse, Estelle, working to the southeast at this time. Rain working to the northeast around LaPlace and Norco towards the Kenner area. And then around Chapultepec is where we see some of those moderate downpours. Manhattan Boulevard on the west bank, Harvey Boulevard, along with Belle Chasse. So wet conditions pretty much for the entire area. Spotty, if you're not dealing with rain now, you will be within the coming moments. There's the frontal boundary still to our west. It will continue to press on to the east as we move throughout the day today. Here's your forecast model by 8:30 showing still rain in the forecast. We'll deal with rain through the morning hours, but as we get closer to noon, that's when we start to see the rainfall working offshore. Isolated showers only remaining. We'll see more sunshine as the day progresses and the clouds will be moving out. The cooler air will start to drain in later on tonight. That'll be a nice feel. Cooler air right now to our west and north. 30 degrees in Billings, Montana. No, no, none of that for us, but we will keep the temperatures cool for this time of the year. Temperatures in the 70s for the North Shore, and those temps have dropped with the help of the drier air working in and the rainfall. Winds are gusting. Here they are, 15 to 24, even 33 miles per hour at the Lakefront Airport. And notice those winds out of the northwest now. So an indication that changes are working through at this time. Partly cloudy skies by 3 o'clock this afternoon, still breezy, and the breezes will stay with us for the rest of this day and through tonight and even early Saturday morning. Speaking of Saturday, here's your 7-day exact cast with afternoon highs, mainly middle 70s, a few upper 70s with lots of sunshine. Saturday night, we drop down into the upper 40s for the North Shore to near 50 and mid and upper 50s for the South Shore. For game day, another great day, temps near 80 degrees. A great weekend in store. Now, here's a look at a great weather picture from Margaret.
Hi, everybody. I tell you, some of the students in Abita Springs did some great weather pictures with dogs, and I love this one. It's from Sophia. Look, the sun is shining. We've got some clouds, and her dog looks like it's a cloud in the sky. Sophia, good-looking weather picture. We're going to send you 2 free Aztec passes to Adventure Quest Laser Tag, where every visit is an adventure, and you get your Audubon Zoo passes. I'll see you back here at 4, 5, 6, and 10.
And right now, if you're traveling along I-10 eastbound, just past maybe the Jefferson Davis Parkway overpass here, we have an accident. It's just past that I-10 exit. If you were going to get off at Slidell, right before that Superdome exit, it's blocking 2 right lanes of traffic at this hour. So if you're traveling to the CBD, you might notice some slight slowdowns getting past that point because only 1 lane is open. So again, 2 right lanes blocked there right now. Also still looking at that accident, I-10 eastbound, if you're traveling towards LaPlace near the Belterre exit. And Still that breakdown lingering there on the West Bank Expressway in the westbound direction, blocking one lane of traffic over the Harvey Tunnel.
JP Morgan's data has been breached, the number of accounts compromised, and the information that hackers were not able to obtain.
A new this morning, JP Morgan Chase says that cyber criminals have gathered information on millions of their account holders. In August, the hackers infiltrated seven of the country's largest banks and used malicious software to manipulate records. They got contact information on 76 million households and 7 million small businesses, including names, addresses, and email accounts. JP Morgan says that they did not get access to any account information like birth dates or social security numbers. And we are still following breaking news for you this morning. A tanker truck explodes near a gas station, killing the driver. Casey Ferran will join us after the break with a live report.
And we're still watching a cold front, which is pushing through and pushing in. Showers and storms in the forecast this morning. Changes for the afternoon. Details coming up.
Well, good morning. As you wake up on this Friday, October the 3rd, here's a live look outside for you.
Yeah, TGIF, everyone. But we do have a lot to talk about this morning. We've got breaking news and slick roads and windy conditions outside. So Quillian Murphy is here with a check of our exact.
All of that happening. Yeah. We do have rain and storms working through. Nothing severe. I like that. Mm-hmm. And that will continue, I think, for much of the morning. Here's a look at the satellite and radar. We'll get straight to it. Rain working in. A nice batch around Baton Rouge and Hammond down through Houma. That's actually associated with the front. Just before the front, we have also prefrontal showers and storms, we call it. These showers and storms break out ahead of the frontal boundary. So we're seeing those now around Long Beach, Biloxi, up through Hurley and Grand Bay right now. So those will continue to work to the east around the metro area, Laplace, down through Des Almonds. We do have some more moderate to heavy rainfall. Lightning starting to pop up now with some of these showers and storms. Also some special marine warnings being issued by the National Weather Service. Laplace, Norco, Luling. If you're running that stretch of I-10, expect wet roadways there. Here we go down to the metro area. We do have some light showers around Chapultepec Street and Napoleon Avenue. These showers and storms will continue through the morning. I will have details on your ExactCast, which includes a drier afternoon and a breezier afternoon. All that coming up.
Well, right now, if you're traveling across I-10 eastbound towards the CBD, we do have one accident just past that I-10 Slidell exit. If you're traveling towards the Superdome this morning, it's blocking two lanes of traffic at this hour, so that means only one lane is passable. So you may notice some more stack ups. This is a live look at I-10 eastbound at South Jefferson Davis Parkway. Not too bad, but you are seeing those delays building earlier than what you would typically see them. Otherwise, we've got one accident, I-10 eastbound at the Belterre exit if you're traveling towards Laplace, and a breakdown on the West Bank Expressway westbound at the Harvey Tunnel. We're also still following breaking news this morning. A tanker truck explodes, killing the driver and sending flames shooting into the sky.
This all happened around 2 a.m. this morning at a gas station located at the intersection of Franklin and North Claiborne Avenues. That's where we find WDSU News reporter Casey Ferran with how it all started. Casey?
Ladies, there's still a lot of fire crews on the scene right now, as well as police crews. They're trying to investigate exactly what happened here this morning. Right now, the scene is beginning to clear out, and they're cleaning up some of the debris and the crash scene. If you take a look behind me, you can see the sign that the tanker truck hit right here on the property of the gas station. It hit that truck after the tanker truck apparently tried to swerve and get away from hitting another SUV in the area. So we've now learned that the tanker truck driver has died. Police have now been speaking to the driver of the SUV, who apparently had disappeared for a little bit of time, but they have found her at this point. They're speaking to her to find out exactly what happened this morning. But we do know that right now, energy crews are on the scene trying to get power back to some of the area. The power was knocked out. Apparently a transformer was hit here, and neighbors in this area don't have electricity. Some don't have cable or internet at this time. And the crews are still working to kind of clean up the scene at this point. And there is evacuations within a half mile radius of this area. They're trying to keep people out of this area. So this is a very busy intersection on a normal day, but right now there's just a lot of cleanup efforts underway right now to make sure that this investigation is complete. So we'll get you more details within the next few minutes. And we did, as we did point out, this is at a gas station right here on North Claiborne and Franklin Avenue. And we did talk to PIO earlier, who told us about the time that they took to get this fire under control was because it was so close to a gas station. They had to cut off those pumps as well to make sure everything else would be safe and that the fire crews would be safe on the scene. On your side, I'm Casey Ferran, WDSU News.
Casey, thank you for that. And this video was sent in to WDSU from a viewer this morning when the fire first ignited at roughly 2 a.m. You can see the explosion right there in the background as it starts to pan as that three-alarm fire started. But again, since then, crews have managed to get things under control, and right now it is only a one-alarm fire. And again, there are a lot of fire crews still out there on the scene. You also heard Casey say about 500 Entergy customers are still in the dark this morning. The power went out in the same area around the same time as that deadly tanker truck fire, and it is because of that deadly explosion. So Entergy crews are on the scene investigating the incident, checking things out. The power should be back on around 7:30 this morning. Now, WDSU will continue to bring you updates on this story on air and online at WDSU.com. Also, don't forget to download our smartphone app. There you can get all of our breaking news alerts to get the most up-to-date information.
And Randy, we have more power outage to report to viewers this morning. Right now, more than 4,000 Entergy customers are out of power, and this is going on in Waggaman. Crews also on the scene at that location trying to figure out what caused this power outage. But again, 4,000 customers of Entergy without power in Waggaman. Officials say that everything should be restored around 8 o'clock this morning. We'll keep you posted.
At 6:37 now, changes are coming to the evidence room at criminal court that could slow down operations. Starting next week, the evidence room will be by appointment only Tuesday through Thursday and open all day just Monday and Friday. Clerk of Court Arthur Morrell says the reduction in hours is because of staffing shortages. He's been in a budget battle with the city for the last 2 years and says his office is not fully funded and the city does not have the liberty to adjust his budget without the approval of state lawmakers.
They are by law mandated to fund my office fully. That's all we've ever asked. If they want to reduce it, the law states a remedy. They're to go to the legislature and present to the legislature why my budget should be reduced. They've never done that.
Now, the issue was in court this week, and the city sent us this statement saying, quote, the Fourth Circuit Court of Appeals agreed that the city of New Orleans has the legal right to set funding levels for the office of the criminal district clerk of court at a discretionary amount. Furthermore, we are confident that evidence will prove the city has met all legal obligations in this matter, end quote.
This morning, Entergy has asked the Louisiana Public Service Commission for permission to merge. Entergy Louisiana and Entergy Gulf States want to form one utility company. Entergy provides service to New Orleans suburbs all the way to Monroe. Entergy Gulf States manages areas from Baton Rouge all the way to the Texas state line. Representatives say the move will allow companies to make continuous investments. Entergy expects to invest more than $5 billion in the state's energy infrastructure by 2019. And also, while the Public Service Commission rolls that one over, it did approve a one-time refund for Entergy customers in Louisiana. So if you're an Entergy Louisiana customer, you're going to get $7.50 back, while Entergy Gulf States customers will get more than double that at $16.75. Customers can see the refunds by the end of this month, and this is all because of a lawsuit that's brought on by the commission against Entergy over how the company spreads the cost of electric generation.
So in Baton Rouge, a new software development company based in India will open up a new office at the Louisiana Technology Park. Stixis Technologies chose Louisiana over five other states and says it'll bring with it 230 new jobs. Stixis provides technology consulting, software product development, and the jobs will have an average salary close to $60,000.
And right now, police need your help finding the man here on your screen. They say 46-year-old Vernon Davis Jr. was last seen over the weekend in New Orleans East on West Rockton Circle. Now, Davis was driving a 2011 Toyota Camry with Louisiana license plate VZH733. Officials say he was wearing a green shirt and khaki pants at the time. Please call police if you can help detectives locate where he is.
I know, at 6:39, as we have your weather in traffic every 10 minutes, and it's already a rainy start to your Friday, but yes. The good news, it's not going to wash out your weekend.
That's right. It's not going to wash out your Friday either, Randy. Some changes for the afternoon hours, so that's good. Let's get through the morning. Let's take our time, especially on the roads out there. They'll be slick because the rain is coming down. Thankfully, the showers and storms are moving at a good clip this morning, generally 15 to 20 miles per hour, some even more quickly than that, which means water can't, it doesn't have the opportunity to build up, causing that localized flooding. Now, we could see some heavy downpours with some of these moderate pockets of rain that are working through now. Some of the lightning and storms around the Mississippi Gulf Coast this morning continuing to work to the east, but then as we look out west towards I-55 and Hammond, this is where we find another onslaught of moderate to heavy rainfall that continuing to press on to the east, moving into Lake Pontchartrain now. So over the causeway, expect slick conditions as we look towards the south shore around Luling, LaPlace, the river parishes down through areas around 310, stretching on to the metro area. We do have those areas of moderate showers stretching towards Poydras and Violet so far this morning. Galliano getting in on some scattered showers and storms as well. These continue through this morning, at least through 8 to 10 o'clock or so for metro spots. And as we get closer to noon, this front will continue to push on to the coast. So here's the big picture now. We do have that frontal boundary, which is still to the west. Rain and showers ahead of that front, and that will continue to move on to the east. Here's the progress of the forecast model through 8:30, showing again scattered rain and storms, which will continue by the 1 o'clock hour by noon. Only isolated showers left. Clearing works in, drier conditions work back in, sunshine works back in. The breezes continue to pick up though as we go throughout the day. There's one small warm area of the nation, and that includes New Orleans and areas around Florida. Notice cooler conditions around Jackson, Memphis in the 60s. Temperatures for us will be dropping tonight in the 70s right now, lower 80s towards the coast. Those winds are gusting in the teens, 20s and 30s right now with lower visibilities. We'll see improvement though as we go throughout the day. Cooler conditions tonight in the 50s North Shore, 60s South Shore. The weekend bringing us more sunshine and 70s on Saturday.
All right, thank you for that, Quaylen. Right now, we're still looking at that accident along the Pontchartrain Expressway. So if you were traveling towards the Superdome area this morning, watch out. Two lanes are blocked. We're looking at rubbernecking delays and then delays just trying to get through that accident spot since two lanes are blocked. So pretty much a pretty big mess out there along the Crescent City Connection Bridge and also the Pontchartrain Expressway at this hour. Still looking at an accident, I-10 eastbound at Belterre. And also remember that problem spot right around North Claiborne and right around the Franklin area. That intersection is still closed.
And we are continuing to follow that breaking news this morning where a tanker truck exploded in a gas station and it killed the driver inside. Casey Ferran will join us live with more on what caused the blast.
And don't forget, you'll find our exact weather forecast every weekday morning on Old School 106.7, The Ticket 106.1, Nash 92.3, and Power 102.9.
This is breaking news from WDSU.
And right now we are following that breaking news with a tanker truck exploding this morning, killing the driver and pretty much shutting down the area around
it. This all happened at the intersection of North Claiborne and Franklin. While it is under control right now, crews are still busy working at this moment. That's where we find WDSU news reporter Casey Ferran with how it all started. Casey.
Ladies, a lot of this area is still closed off to traffic right now as crews are trying to investigate exactly what happened here this morning. But what we do know right now is a tanker truck was actually apparently trying to avoid hitting an SUV and ran into the sign at the Quickie gas station here at the corner of North Claiborne and Franklin Avenue. You can actually see if we can get a closer look further back, you can see the SUV further down toward that overpass that was actually hit this morning. Police tell us that the driver of the truck has died this morning in this fire. However, the driver of the SUV, they have located her. She is doing just fine. They're trying to get more information from her about what happened here this morning. But officials did evacuate the Quickie Mart immediately. That store is open 24 hours here at this gas station. And they have had other evacuations within a half mile radius of the store.
Right there being at the gas station. The gas station is a 24-hour food mart and service station. So that was evacuated also. And we want to make sure that we clear the entire area as a precautionary measure.
Now, Now, one of the problems they did have this morning is it's been raining off and on this morning, so that was causing that fire to flare up earlier. So they did have to put down a foam agent to distinguish the fire immediately. And right now, the area is still evacuated, and we're trying to get more details as to when that will be opening up, because I know a lot of drivers will be heading out this morning, and we'll give you more updates online at WDSU.com.
All right, Casey, thank you for that for us live this morning at 6:48. And check out this video that was sent in to us from a viewer. This is video of the fire when it first started right around 2 o'clock this morning. It started off as a two alarm fire. You can see the blast there, right there in the distance. It ramped up to three alarms. And as Casey mentioned, it's now back down to, it was one alarm and is now completely under control, although fire crews are still out there. Also right now, 500 energy customers are still in the dark because of this deadly explosion. You can see the outage map right here affecting a lot of folks right around Claiborne and the upper Ninth Ward. Energy crews are on the scene investigating that right now and tell us that the power should be on around 7:30 this morning. So we'll continue to bring you the latest updates on this story on air and online at WDSU.com. You can also download our smartphone app so you can get all of our breaking news alerts.
Yeah, and Randy, also crews are working on another power outage. This one going on in Waggaman this morning, where we understand more than 4,000 Entergy customers are without power. They are on the scene trying to figure out what caused this outage, but officials tell us that everything should be restored around 8 o'clock this morning, but we will continue to monitor that throughout the morning. The Gretna Music and Heritage Festival returns this weekend, celebrating its 20th birthday.
And in its two decades of operation, it's been a great economic impact to Jefferson and Orleans parishes. And all new this morning, Quaylen Murphy has all the things you need to know before you head out.
Gretna Fest is 20 years old this year.
Isn't that exciting?
It is super exciting.
20 years from one stage, one day, not even one day, 4 hours, one band, 400 people.
Now to 3 days, 6 stages, and over 55 artists.
Hoping this year to achieve 130,000 people or more. So it's really come a long way.
Although the festival has grown over the years, it still offers elements for a small family atmosphere.
We have carnival rides for the kids. We have games for the children. It's a well-supervised festival. Hardly any problems at all to speak of.
If you're looking for a first-class, top-notch view of the fest, there's a skybox just for you with an expansive view of the main stage area.
This particular stage, you'll have all your main acts. You'll have video screens, all the latest in technology for viewing pleasure and sound.
This year, a stage for lovers of indie rock has been added for your listening pleasure. And on another stage, reality star and hip-hop rapper Big Smo will be bringing his country lovin'.
And in fact, he'll be here Saturday at 5:30 with his performance. But the good thing and the great thing about it is, I think that we're going to be all surprised that we'll be part of the reality next season.
There's an exclusive way for you to avoid using the interstate to get to Gretna Fest, and it's all a part of my three things you should know before you go.
First, an exclusive Gretna Fest ferry will be operating through the weekend. Single day and VIP passes are available for purchase, and no pets, ice chests, or outside food or beverages are allowed. Gretna Heritage Fest supports over 60 nonprofit groups.
All these booths that you see out on the festival grounds, inclusive of drink sales and beer sales, all give back to nonprofits who operate all year long and depend upon the Gretna Heritage Festival for their income that they make at the festival to actually survive.
From an economic standpoint, Gretna Fest gives the area a nice boost.
When you talk about hotels, transportation, secondary buying or secondary spending, so it's about a $2 million increase in the economic impact of Jefferson and Orleans Parish.
So take a look at the lineup, make your selection, and head out to Gretna Fest. It's a 20th birthday bash you don't want to miss. On your side from the West Bank, I'm meteorologist Quaylen Murphy, WDSU News.
And all the fun starts today. It runs through Sunday, and you can buy tickets online right now at GretnaFest.com, and it should be some pretty nice weather.
Yeah, let's ask Quaylen what the weather's going to shape up like for those of you who are heading out there.
Oh, my Randy, you know. Just go ahead and tell us. No, gates open at 3 o'clock at Gretna Fest, and the 4 o'clock is when everything gets started. By that time, we'll be in tip-top shape.
Right? Everybody's going to love you this weekend.
Oh, I know. I love that. You know, when we shot that piece, it was so beautiful outside. So we have to get through today, and then we'll get through this afternoon. It'll be the same. Here we go. Here's a look at the satellite radar. I will show you now. Rain moving in. We do have, if you're experiencing dry conditions,
ends now, there's another batch on the way. So that's what we're dealing with now. Much of our rain activity will be through the morning hours, mainly before noon. That rain chance around 70%. Again, you can see the heaviest rainfall still more hefty west of I-55, more spotty and scattered in nature to the east. Again, rain and storms will continue. Slick roadways, wet roadways this morning. These rain rates a little over 1 inch, but because these storms are moving so quickly, don't expect that we're capturing that much when we see these moderate pockets working over the region. Here's a look at the metro area, and we do have some areas of drizzle working in, and more so drawing your attention to I-10 and the expressway, because many of you commuting over this expressway this morning. So again, looking out for that, taking your time, taking your roll, slowing your roll this morning. Mississippi Gulf Coast seeing isolated showers and storms as well. They will continue to press on to the east. The big picture showing this large swath of moisture surging to the east, all associated and up front of that cold frontal boundary. Drier air behind the front in Texas right now will continue to push on to the east. So we have drier conditions in store for the afternoon hours. Rain again with us through the morning. This is 9 o'clock. Your forecast model is showing the conditions still wet for some spots, but by noon and by 1 o'clock, drier conditions. Not only that, the skies start to clear. We start to see gradual clearing, which will persist through the late afternoon hours, early evening and overnight. So with clear skies and winds out of the north, temperatures tonight will be falling. 71 degrees right now at the airport in New Orleans, 74 for the lakefront airport. Notice the South Shore. We have those temperatures in the 70s and 80s, but Hammond down to 68 degrees. It's going to be a nice start to the morning. 71 degrees, at least feel wise. Wind gusts 15 to 20, even 30 miles per hour. Keep that in mind. Lock down anything on your porch this morning. Visibility's fluctuating with the rain. That will also be a hindrance this morning, so be careful. 88 degrees. Here's your 7-day exactcast. Temperatures on Saturday, 70s. It's going to be nice.
And after the break, we're going to take a look at the 6 things you need to know before you head out the door, including the latest on that deadly tanker fire along North Claiborne at Franklin, as you take a live look out there at this hour. We'll be right back. Well, we just have a few minutes left before we go.
We want to leave you with 6 things you need to know before you head out the door.
And right now, a man is dead after the tanker truck that he was driving exploded near a convenience store, a gas station, sparking a 3-alarm fire. Officials say shortly after 2 a.m., the driver swerved to try and avoid a car, but hit a sign near Quickie's gas station on Franklin and North Claiborne. Now, the fire has since been put out, and firefighters are monitoring the diesel spill from the truck right now, making sure that the rain doesn't cause any flare-ups. This is a live picture from the scene right now of what that tanker truck looks like at this hour.
An American freelance cameraman working for NBC News in Liberia has tested positive for Ebola. Will be flown back here to the United States for treatment. When he gets here, he and 2 other people will be quarantined for at least 21 days.
The city is transitioning to new solar-powered parking meters. The first ones were installed earlier this week in the CBD, and you'll see them in the French Quarter pretty soon. By the end of the year, all the parking meters will be replaced with new ones, which include video touch screens. And the director of Public Works will talk about this at 9 a.m. later today.
And changes are coming soon to the evidence room at criminal court that could slow down operations. Starting next week, the evidence room will be by appointment only, Tuesday through Thursday, and open all day on Monday and Friday. Here's Quaylen Murphy with a quick check of your ExactCast.
And we'll be going from wet to dry real quick for the weekend. Lots of sunshine, temps in the 70s.
And right now, the biggest problem on your roadways is going to be right over the Pontchartrain Expressway. If you're traveling from the West Bank to the East Bank right now, there's an accident right around Chapultepec blocking 2 lanes of traffic. Delays right now all the way back to Terry Parkway. Yeah, if you typically drive that route, you know how bad those delays are. So Terry Parkway all the way to the Crescent City Connection Bridge, very slow going. You also see slow going traffic in the opposite direction. Those of you traveling inbound from the Carrollton Overpass, so keep that in mind as well.
Yeah, and during the cut-ins, we're going to keep you posted on the tanker fire that we've been reporting as breaking news all morning. So keep it right here on WDSU News this morning.
And don't forget, you can always get the latest online at WDSU.com. Have a great day.